Hi, YouTube family. It's Daughter of the Most High. I hope you're having a really good weekend so far. I'm having a good weekend, and we're getting some snow here, and we're getting more than they predicted. So I'd rather get that snow on the weekend than on the weekdays. I don't like that long drive to work. So how about that, huh? So I have three videos for you today. I don't always find that many videos in a day, but today I did, and I've spent a fair amount of time in front of my computer. So, and I just made a video sharing about a little bit about the three videos. And then I realized after I, you know, finished making my video, I thought, was I careful about what I said? So I went through and I listened to my own video, which, again, I don't want to do. I mean, I spent enough time watching the videos doing that. Anyway, I did it. And sure enough, I said something that I shouldn't have. And so now I've got to redo it. So you're going to probably get the mini version here because I just got done saying all of this and here I am again. So that happens. I think it happens to anybody that makes a video. There's people that know how to edit. This girl doesn't. So here we are again, guys. Round two. So anyway, I got some videos I want to share with you. Look for the links in the description box. The first one is from her channel is called Changes Coming Soon. And I don't listen to her real often, but she posted this video today. She had this dream today. And I found it pretty interesting. And it was actually when I was sharing this about this in my previous video that I messed up on my words. So I'm being a little cautious here. So her video is called Warning Dream. Oh, pardon me. Warning Dream. Surprise Attack to Force. The M-A-R-K. No warning, be prepared. So, and it's actually really good. I think her video is really good and kind of scary. And it is 24 minutes long. And as I share, you know, about, you know, certain videos that you can kind of get the gist of the video about like halfway through it. So you don't have to watch the whole thing. And that's actually true of one of the other videos that I'm going to share in a minute by a doctor. And what they do is they share the main point of their video and then reiterate, and that's what happens. And so we really, not that we want to spend, you know, hours in front of the computer, we don't. And so, but again, you're always welcome to watch the whole video, but we know that most of us watch many, and we do kind of like, okay, well, you know, I got the point of this, and then we can be done. So, but I just want to add one other little thing there. Further into her video, if you do end up listening to the whole thing, is that she does mention that she believes she is one of the 144,000. And that kind of surprised me. And I do want to still share the video, but don't let that throw you. Because she's in error regarding that, but that doesn't mean everything's in error. God gave her this dream, and I think it's something that we all, you know, I think we know about already, but I think it's just important to share it. I enjoyed hearing her dream. Yeah, and so the 144,000 are 12,000 Jews from each of the 12 tribes, and they're sealed in the end times to... it's so glorious to just do the work of God, and then they're just sealed. They're perfectly sealed. They don't have to be in fear. They can just, you know, complete their mission, do what they need to do, share the gospel, do what, you know, and they're completely covered. I mean, sign me up. Yeah, I would, I would do that like in a minute, like God would come to me and say, do you want to do this? Yes, I want to do this. The thing that we all, you know, that kind of strikes our fear sometimes is that we don't know what we're going to have to go through. And so, yeah, it'd be nice to just be one of the protected. I mean, we have protection, but we're not like encapsulated like the 144 are. So at least that's my understanding of it. But so anyway, when she does say that, if you do listen to the whole video, yeah, don't let that throw you. So that's one of them. The second one is, and this is from the channel Unheard, capital UN, capital HERD. And I am not subscribed to this channel, so this just came across my feed. Anyway, it's called Inside Australia's COVID Internment Camp. And what this camp is it's a camp for people that have COVID or are possibly or were exposed to COVID, so that, meaning that they might become positive with it. So this young girl, she's 26, shares her story of what happened. And I'm going to tell you, this stuff, I mean, whether it's a camp because you're not following the agenda or because you're sick with COVID or whatever, I don't want either way. I don't want any of it. But I'll let her share her experience with you. And her video is 20 minutes long. She's being interviewed. They did not ask in this video, which I kept waiting for them to. It's like, what if you have kids? What if you have dogs? What if you have horses? What if you have, you know, whatever you have? And all of a sudden, yeah, they come to pick you up and they, it's like, oh. So, and in the comments below this, it says, where'd it go? Here it is. This horrific treatment has caused massive trauma to so many. My sister and her family were treated so poorly when moving from NSW to NT. Their dog was removed from them and consequently disappeared. They were unable to look for him, and the trauma of being locked up and helpless has caused significant mental trauma to the whole family. They were treated like criminals. All COVID negative. Their beloved dog was never found. I cannot believe this inhumane treatment exists in our country. So that's one of the comments below her video. Yeah, it's just sad, just sad. So anyway, I'll let her share her story with you. And then my other video that I have today, and this one's really sad. This was on a Facebook post. And what's really sad about this is that this video is by Dr. Andreas, a male, Nowak, N-O-A-C-K. And he shared a video about his discovery. Now, he shares about his profession and all that kind of stuff, and I don't even fully get that. I don't. Sometimes I'm so amazed by what people do for their work. They're, like, so smart. and so he understands this, and he researched it and found that the graphene oxide is not, in fact, that. It is graphene, I don't even know how to say it, like a hydroxide. Hang on one second here. Let me see if I can get this.
Yeah, well, just a quick info.
Where does he say that? Is it hydroxide? I'm not sure. Anyway, you'll see it in the video. and that is actually like, he explains it well, but I'll try to say a little bit. It actually is like little sharp razors inside your body and in your bloodstream. And this video was posted on a Facebook post where they shared the list of like over 80, 85 people who died shortly thereafter getting the snake bite because of this very thing happening in their body. And he talks a little bit about that. This video is probably, what is it, 18, 19 minutes long. And again, you don't have to watch the whole thing because he does make his point. He gets to his main point by about halfway through. The sad thing that I want to tell you is that he got arrested after making this live video on 11/28, so not very long ago, and was dead within 8 hours. He was beaten to death, and his wife shares a video. So the man that made this video to share this truth was, and he's from, gosh, is it Austria? Guys, I'm a little bit maxed on, I think it was Austria that this guy is from. Anyway, you'll have to look. I'm getting a little bit tired of now. I'm making my own video for a second time. So my voice is even drying out. So anyway, look for that. But that's so sad. So that's just more information about the snake bite and what's really going on. So I found it pretty interesting. They share some links below about that information. I was just telling you about the doctor. And so then you can actually research that further if you choose to. So yikes. But my voice is really drying out. So I'm going to wrap up here. And so look for those three video links in the description box and have a really good rest of your weekend, fam. Thank you.